Anybody want to buy kids? Oh, I thought no video.
Oh, well.
I.
Yes or no?
This is Luke chapter 13, verse 23 to 27. Some asked him, Lord, are only few people going to be saved? He said to them, make every effort to enter through the narrow door, because many. I tell you, we'll try to enter and will not be able to. Once the owner of the house get up and close the door, you will stand outside, knocking and pleading, sir, open the door for us. But he will answer, I don't know you or where you come from. Then you will say, we ate and drank with you. You taught in our street. But he will reply, I don't know you or where you come from. Away from me, all you evil doer. This scripture gives us very, very serious message. Some ask Jesus, Lord, are only few going to be saved? Jesus said, make every effort enter through the narrow gate, because many, I tell you, try to enter and will not be able to. What does this mean? What does this mean? Narrow gate does not mean that few will save. Few will save means only few will believe and obedience and follow. Therefore, make every effort for that reason. Many will try to enter and will not be able to. This means many people do not believe. So, everybody has a map of own life, right? If the map is not accurate, you will get lost and not know where we are or where are you going. So map needs to be constantly rewrite. Just like an app, it needs to be constantly updated. Because the world and the environment are changing. Especially in today's world, even our church think are changing dramatically and literally. But we still treasure and use old map. Why? Because preconception. They cannot think out of the box. The more successful people has the strong preconception. If you have a strong conception, preconception, there's no future. Because living in the past, Jesus said, all you evil doers, are they bad people? No, just said, they are drunk with Jesus, eat with Jesus, they listen to Jesus teach. They are not bad people. They are Jesus supporter and forward, but they couldn't say. They couldn't say. Also, Luke chapter 13, verse 28 to 30. There will be weeping there and
gnashing.
A tease. When you see Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and all the prophets in the kingdom of God, but you yourselves throw out. They want to say that. We are same Israelites. We are same lineage from Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. Please open the door. Bam, bam, bam. Also, people will come from east and west and north and south. and will take their place at the feast in the kingdom of God. Indeed, there are those who will first, and first will who will be last. God invited people from all over the world. They take their places at the first, feast in the kingdom of God. Are there something special? They made a donation, or make special sincere condition, witness a lot of people. They were not the kind of people. They were just ordinary people. Maybe they some of the commit sin or made a lot of mistakes. So why did God invite them into his kingdom? I think only one reason. Their response to God's call. They believe and obeyed without doubt. That means that such people can enter through the narrow door. This is what it means that few are saved. I try to find out what kind of people can enter Chonburi and live there. How many years have you been in church? Which was comfortable? How many people witness and become famous lecture? How much did you donate? All this doesn't matter. What is important is belief and obedience. I have a funny story. Long time ago, when I was in Japan, working for the church business, it's called Happy World. I'm selling the Yoruba ginseng. Very expensive. And one day, my territory finished. Then I asked my central leader, my territory finished, give me new territory. I believe that God works with me. And then he opened the map, and then he pointed, this place. Go to this place tomorrow. And then I went to there, and my first one, oh my God, because huge forest, just forest. And I did. I have to believe it. Maybe somebody lived there. And then I went to the forest. Tree and tree, 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 nothing but tree. And finally, I found one house. Actually, small community center. And then I saw the one lady cleaning in entrance area. And the door is double door, so clean. I hit my head on purpose. And then she laughing. And then, did you clean the door? Yes, I did. Still smell. Yes, you did a good job. I couldn't see that. And then she bought one ginseng, 500. She bought the four.
Oh, so my God.
$2,000, he said.
Oh, wow.
And also Jesus did heal the people. Those who receive healing, also they are to faith in Jesus. This one story. One guy came to Jesus with a chair. Lord, my daughter just died. But I believe if you touch my daughter, her life come back again. Please come to my house. And Jesus went there and Jesus said to him, don't worry. She's just sleeping and she woke up. Because he believed Jesus. So this is the True Mother's Book last July. If you become one with the true mother, only begotten daughter, you will be able to enter the kingdom of heaven on earth. And in heaven, this is something you must know. You know, true mother doesn't ask us something special. Only one thing, you become one with me. Originally, my title was Who is my Sherpa? Anybody know about Sherpa? Okay, go ahead, explain.
Sherpa are people living high up in the Himalayas who act because they can't bring animals very high altitude, so they carry their carriers of luggage or baggage or materials they carry on their back. Mostly now they're tourists and mountain climbers going up Everest.
Yeah, that's right. You know, climbing the Himalayas alone is impossible. That's why you need a guide called Sherpa, who has many years of experience. For example, somebody is addicted to something. It is impossible to overcome alone, no matter how strong your mind or body is. It's impossible. You need the help of an experienced professional, just like a Sherpa. Bible John 14 and 6 say, I am the way and the truth and life. No one comes to the Father except through me. This is the same for true mother. I am the way and the truth and life. No one comes to the heavenly parents except through me. I think our true mother is our shepherd. Our shepherd will guide us to the top of the mountain. Also, Luke chapter 13, verse 28. Once owner of the house get up and close the door. Talking about the time limit. Once owner of the house has closed the door, it's too late. I interpreted it in this way. I interpreted the closing of door at the end of true mother's life. This is my interpretation. Last week, the true mother said that I have said that the blessed family living in this era are living in a golden age. This time, when only begotten daughter, true mother is still living on earth, is the only golden age. There has not been one before, and will never be one again. Paralympics were held after the Paris Olympics. One of the competitions was the blind marathon. Of course, they cannot run alone. They need a guide runner, run together. They run together, avoid the obstacle or giving the direction. Also, they run holding onto about 10 inches of rope. It's called a bond. It's called bond, holding together. When I saw that, I was so moved because that exactly relates me and God. We can see that, but we are blind. That's why we lost. We went the wrong way. We are spiritually blind, but believe that, please believe, we hold right rope. It's called bond, me and God. So believing God and holding to the Lord without ever letting go. Someday, God will guide you to your destination. Okay? Thanks so much. This morning. Heavenly parents, how would you today talk about that narrow door? Simple says believe. It is what is a believe is simple, but with our heart, with our spirit, our soul, not easy. Just say that many people try to go to the narrow door, but only few believe. Because a lot of people cannot believe. Today we study very serious message, but also we are living in a very, very blessing time because live with two mother called God and is the first. So every prayer, please give us believe heart. Believing heart makes impossible possible. Every prayer. I believe you are holding life rope. You cannot see. But please don't let go us. We hold it tight, never let it go. Please, please, yes. Just we saw that you cannot stop. You never stop. You are way maker. You are miracle maker. Heal the people. We believe. Please. Give us right heart, right motivation, right path. Make us only be with us. Thank you so much this morning. Please bless brothers and sisters and give us a joyful life and happy life. And we